Hello everyone! In this episode, we will learn how to use the useDebugValue hook and the useLayoutEffect hook. As you can see, I already have our application up and running using npm start, so let's get to it. As always, I'll start by importing the hooks. So, at the top of the app.js file, I am just going to add useDebugValue and useLayoutEffect to our hook list. Save. And now let's start with the easier one, the useDebugValue hook. This hook allows you to display label for a custom hook in the React DevTools. Let me show you an example. If I scroll down below to the useLocalStorageValue hook, I am just going to add useDebugValue right about here, and here let's type custom label. I have saved, and now if I head over to my React components tree in the console, this is part of the React DevTools, and I click the app component on the right side, I can see our local storage value hook along with our custom label. You probably won't need to do this in your application, but it is a good thing to do when you are, for example, building a hook library. Now let's move to the useLayoutEffect hook. This hook is very similar to the useEffect hook. The only difference is that it runs before the components are rendered, but after the JSX tree has been adjusted. Just to remind you, the useEffect hooks runs after all of the components have been rendered. In other words, the useLayoutEffect hooks runs just before the browser has a chance to paint the new DOM changes. This means that the useLayoutEffect hook is the ideal place to possibly adjust some styles, scroll values, stuff like this. Let me once again show you an example. In the app component, let's create a useEffect hook that will change our page background color like this. So I'll type useEffect, pass in the function, pass an empty array, and inside let's do document.body.style.backgroundColor, and let's set it to 000. Save. And if I reload the page every second, you can see a short blink of a white color because the useEffect hook changes the color after the initial render. However, if I change our hook like this to the useLayoutEffect, so useLayoutEffect, save, and I close my console because this really kind of messes with the rendering, and now if I refresh, you can see nothing is happening. Now sometimes we might see a white flash, but most of the time this is working. This is a bit of a weird way to demonstrate this, but it should be enough for you to understand the difference between the useEffect and useLayoutEffect hooks. Now let me quickly comment this out, and that's all for this episode. In the next one, we will learn about the last remaining React hook, the useImperativeHandle hook. If you have any suggestions or questions, let me know in the comments and I'll answer every single one of them. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to leave a like and subscribe to see more videos like this in the future. Thanks for watching.